Good afternoon. Actually, we are now passing afternoon near evening. So better to say good evening. Dear students, we are discussing about bank management. Very subsequent, very important thing in the money market, capital market, in the financial affairs. It's a very sensitive, tough thing. Though we deliver our lecture and points we mention from the traditional point of view, but actually this is becoming very tough, very sensitive and keen discussion and practices are now day by day needed. In the traditional method, I mean, banking practices were in the analog form, but now it's digital, and digital world is developing so fastest. Each and every day there is a change. Each and every day, not only each and every day, each and every moment there is a change. And then counter, regular and counter practices are continuing. So anyway, first, you all know this is a virtual class. I'm Zaghlul Pasha. You, the senior level students, you're the students of, I'm in BBA fourth year. BBA fourth year management honors. You are already matured. And in one sense, you are lucky enough. You are very much connected with the virtual world. And this virtual world, actually, I started my academic stay in the year 1968, almost 52 years before. Now the world is quite different. What we gathered by 50 years, you can gather that knowledge within 15 days, and that's possible. So clear information, so authentic information, fact-based information with material, paperwork, logistics, and all these things are very much obeyed now, just like all the cards on the table. It's possible now. But in our time, when we were a student of university, that was not possible. We had to depend simply upon books, some manuals and journals upon. And those manuals and journals was prepared and developed with several months practicing. But now what's going on? Just what's happening in now in the USA market, or the banking system of Federal Reserve System of Bank of England, what's going on, or Swiss Bank, or Japanese Bank, Nippon Jinko, Deutsche Bank, all information and messages are coming then and there, with this automation, with this technology. Our information bank is becoming very rich. Even then, some traditional discussions are also concerned here, though technical and technological devices are adopted in the banking system more and more. As per the Oxford Dictionary of Business, bank deposits means a sum of money placed by a customer with a bank. The deposit may or may not attract interest, may be instantly accessible or accessible at a time agreed by the two parties. But someone is keeping a certain amount of money, depositing a certain money in a bank, then that is bank deposit. It may be an individual one or a group of persons or by a company or group of companies, whatever. But when they are keeping their money with interest, without interest, then that's a bank deposit. Now the banking world is becoming versatile and widening. The sources of funds, sources of deposits are now increasing day by day, and multi-varied sources are now developing. Simply the people within the country or simply the companies or simply the organizations within the country is not enough. Now this has been extending. Even the foreign individuals, foreigners, may keep their money here in the bank. Even the also foreign banks can keep their money. Even some resourceful country, even some countries may keep their money, keep their fund as a reserve here in our country. Few days before, Arabian countries, some maybe Qatar, they asked for $100 crore to keep in Bangladesh Bank. They proposed. Like this, different organizations of the world, throughout the world, they can keep their deposit, they can keep their money, they can keep, preserve their fund here in the any our commercial bank or even in central bank of the country. So this is deposit. Anyway, there are some types of deposits. That is number one, current deposit. Generally business persons or business organizations or some government organizations also, they keep deposit as current basis. I mean here rate of interest bank which provide, that is at a lower rate, minimum rate or without rate. But the concept is this: anytime, any moment, whenever the depositors asking for money, there's a placing check to the bank. Then and there, the bank is bound to clear up that payment. So that is the current deposit. Generally, the business persons, I told it earlier, to mitigate their urgent requirement, banks provide this sort of deposit system. Then the savings deposit. Yes, savings deposit generally is for the students, housewives, employees, businessmen, professionals, or basically for the lower earning people, they maintain this sort of the savings deposit. Some old guys also, and some guys are there also, those whose sons and daughters are in the foreign country, they are also selling money from foreign, say for the USA, Canada, Germany, or for the Middle East countries. They are sending money through the banking channel to their father, mother, or their sister or brother or near relatives, etc. and etc. So this is here the rate of interest is little bit higher than the current deposit. At present, maybe in Bangladesh it's maybe 4 to 5% rate of interest, not more than that. So savings account, account holders can enjoy some benefits. But say for a certain account holder wants to get purchase an automobile vehicle, then and there the bank is ready to provide loan facilities to that client. If the client is regular and honest in manner, then banks are very much inclined and interested to provide loan facilities to that one. For that, this sort of banks can provide loan facilities for purchasing apartments, car, households, etc. and etc. Then another term or fixed deposit. Term or fixed deposit basically for the rich guys, those who are those who wants to keep their money for the longer version in the bank as deposit. Sometimes some handsome salary drawer, they can keep a certain amount of money, say for the 10 lakhs, 20 lakhs, 50 lakhs taka in the bank. Or sometimes the retired persons, those who after getting the after retirement, when they're getting a certain amount of money, say for the 50 lakhs, 40 lakhs, 30 lakhs, whatever the amount, or then more, maybe even it can be 1 crore. But valid documents, they can keep this money as a reserve, as a fixed deposit in the bank. Rate of fixed deposit is higher than the current deposit, savings deposit, and it's higher. So, see, if someone is keeping his money as a fixed deposit, say for the 10 lakhs, after 5 years or 6 years, it will be twice. Just 10 will be converted into 20 lakhs. So, in the very old age, this money will support him and provide him the ample opportunity to mitigate the financial crisis or challenges. Okay, then method of collection of bank deposits. Yes, the methods of collecting the bank deposits is the number one, that is encouraging for giving deposit to potential depositors. Yes, banks has to always search the potential depositors and customers from the different sources, different areas, locations, those who are serving, those who are doing businesses, those who are practicing in the as a professional, say for the lawyer, engineer, doctor, or some other guys of the business persons, those who are doing, their bank has to search such type of clients. So they will be inclined and they will keep their money in the bank. As a result, if they do regularly deal with that bank, then bank will also time to time provide loan facilities or other financial support and cooperation to that client. Then giving form for opening deposit accounts. Yes, banks are, if banks are satisfied with the client, bank will encourage the client to open an account, and accordingly bank will provide opening form, account opening form to that client, and clearly express what to do, very in the easiest manner, so that the client will be able to open account in that bank. Signature card, picture, snap, what the items are needed. If it's a joint account, then obviously joint pics are needed, and the joint signatories are needed in the same time. So receiving application form with the necessary, oh yeah, I just told it earlier, receiving application, and with the very receiving of the application form, then and there the necessary papers and documents the clients will provide to the bank. So with the satisfaction, bank will permit them to open the account. If you say partnership form of business, then obviously trade license and agreement, deed of agreement and partnership, the name, those who will operate the account, operator's name will be very much clearly expressed, and their signatures will be in the, signature form. Then, examine the receipt form and documents. Yes, the banks then will have to examine all sorts of forms and documents for opening account, as the bank is asking for the partnership form. If it's a partnership, partnership firms account, then obviously deed of partnership, deed and agreement among the partners, and agreement among the partners for operators, in favor of the operators. So if it's a company, then the name of the MD, name of the chairman, at the same time name of the directors, memorandum of the company, articles of the company, and at the same time trade license and necessary papers and documents those are needed to submit to the bank. Then, and the bank will also verify all these papers and documents, and then bank will lastly permit it to open the account. Evaluate the depositor and giving grade. Yes, If the quality depositors are there, then they will be highly graded A, B, C, D like this way. There will be a grading. For the class 1 grading, the operators will be able to enjoy the multiple loan facilities or other banking supports and cooperation in favor of that operator or that organization, those who are opening the bank account. Then approve for opening deposits, and after with satisfying all these papers and documents and satisfying about the operator, then the bank will allow to open the deposit accounts. Then giving deposits account number and receive deposits, yes, then with this very satisfaction the bank manager and the concerned officers, and they will permit to open the bank account, and they will give you a number and receive the first deposit amount. So fill up the specimen signature card. Obviously there will be a specimen signature card. If there is a personal account, then name of that one, that personal Mr. Safe or Mr. John, he is opening an account, and his signature, a specimen signature will be given in the card. And if Mr. Hassan and Kamal, on chairman and another is the managing director of the company, they are not, and they will have to signature in the a specimen signature card. Then given checkbook, yes, if the bank is satisfied, if they are giving permission to the operator for opening an account, then they will provide checkbook. So this is the thing. Then importance objectives of bank account. What is the importance and objectives of bank deposit? That is the number one, formulating capital. Yes, without depositing, banks can't formulate capital. Without collecting and procuring funds from the different sources, from the clients, from the regular customer, from the depositors, or even nowadays what's going on, FDI is a very smart source of funding and deal. So bank will have to think for depositing a certain amount of money. And at the same time, nowadays some foreign countries are also very much interested to deposit a huge amount of money from one central bank to another central bank. Also, the different organizations or the FDI, they are also sending money to the keeping deposit. And then to give loan, yes, this deposit is collected to form a fund, and this fund will be provided as the loan to the different trade, commerce and business organizations and the industrial organizations also. And say there is a giant businessman, Mr. Bishwajit, so far we know, and he is so many times is receiving huge amount of money for business purpose. And there's the thing, the like this Mr. Kamal, Hassan, John, multiple businessmen, industrialists are there. Then the question of investment, yes, and the multiple sector bank can go for investing a huge amount of money. So purchasing bonds, securities, share, debentures from the different sources, even treasury bond. And this is where, with purchasing this treasury bond after a certain period of time with the maturity, bank can earn a huge amount of money as a profit, as an interest or service charge. Like this, creation, the opportunity and opportunity of employments. Yes, banks providing loan facilities to the, and nowadays what's going on, the SME is a very huge practice countrywide. And this SME loan is providing a small amount of money, and for with that money, they can start a business venture or service business like this way. And so they can generate their own employment side by side, employment of other people's unemployed guys. So this is the system of or creating employment generation is a bank. And then to operate the bank, yes, bank has to operate it. If there is no money, then no bank can operate in business. So positively, bank needs a huge amount of deposits to operate, to organize their banking operations and functions as a whole. So huge fund, nice organization, nice banking and nice practice. Use fund, then not only they will be able to do their business within the country, they can also cross the limits, they can do business abroad. Now it is going on, the bank to bank, internationally transaction is going on. One bank of Bangladesh, they can go for investing to the another bank of South Africa, this or the Arabian bank can invest here in the Bangladeshi bank. This is going on practice. So, like Mr. I got information and a service holder, Mr. Rajan, he is also purchasing and procuring agricultural land in his home district. He is not having and holding huge amount of money. He is taking loan from the banks and the financial institutions. Therefore, the leasing company is also providing loan. And with that financial facilities and support and backup from the banks and the financial institutions, he is purchasing. And day by day, the price of the land is increasing. Also, he is enjoying the crops this way. And he is developing and changing his situation and financial strength. And banks are providing. At the same time, there are so many giant industries without bank facilities and loan. It's not possible to run a giant industries, means and factories, to mitigate the challenges, upcoming challenges. Also, the export-oriented industries, banks is providing support LC and also back-to-back LC. Providing the back-to-back LC support, the exporters can procure the raw materials and they can pay the regular worker salaries and payments, etc. and etc. This is the facilities of the banking. These are the main objectives. And overall also, there is a great objective from the side. Bank is also works as the banker of the government, of the central bank also. Political government holds so many financial policies. And to mature up these financial policies is not possible without bank. And bank can provide the financial support and backup to the government and can act as the financial collaborator. Collaborator, the term is very badly used. It's not co-partner can act as that. For the development works and activities, say for me, roads, bridges, culverts, ports, all, and mitigating the operating expenditures. Government can take or receive loans from the banks and financial institutions. So, these are the concept and by time we will go for discussion. It's already 25 minutes to 26 minutes gone, and I will discuss in the next. Three points I like to mention before ending this matter. That is the sources of collection of bank deposits. What are the sources? Individual area, yes. Individual point of view, personally, a service holder or businessman, a housewife or a student or shopkeeper, they can open an account to keep their regular deposit in the bank. Then the institutional fields, yes, institutional fields require trade organization, academic institutions, welfare institutions, industrial organizations, NGOs, etc. and etc. They can keep their money in the bank. And then the government may keep their huge amount of deposit in the bank. Whenever they need, the government will receive it back from the bank. Okay? So the students, the smart students, the smart boys, I'm just telling you to develop your English spoken at the same time, side by side. As you know, a huge FDI is coming from the different countries of the world, basically from China, Japan, Arabian countries, and Western world. So you need to learn, you need to be fluent enough in spoken English and side by side. You need to learn Chinese, Japanese, or Arabian language, Arabic language, okay? Otherwise, you will complete your BBA, MBA, Masters, but in the job sector, you will become hopeless. So, you need to have some sort of the vocational training. You need to know commercial paperwork, documentation. You need to know how to deal the port handling and the business activities, how to open a bank account, how to have a trade license, export-import license, formation of the company or registration of the partnership business or registration of the company, private limited or public limited. What is the Securities Exchange Commission? You need to know. You need to know about the bond securities, the stocks, about. Okay, these are the things. Government is a great factor. So I have told you I am ending the delivery. Now it's almost evening. Immediately you will hear Allahu Akbar azan of Maghrib. Thank you very much. Good luck. Best of luck.